Good morning. My name is Mr. Muloke, teacher of literature in English. Once again, I've come to you to continue with my presentation on how to analyze a novel in literature in English. In my previous presentation, I talked about two literary devices which are very important. I talked about metaphor. I talked about a simile. I defined what a metaphor is and gave some examples. I defined also a simile and gave some examples. Today I want to continue with the three other literary devices. You understand as a literary scholar, you need to understand and to know the literary devices. Literary devices are very important because this is just a dictionary or a handbook of anyone who is doing literature or wants to understand more literature. Literary devices are very important and very cardinal. The first literary devices I'm going to talk about today is called irony. What is an irony? An irony is just a literary device where the speaker or the writer use the opposites of what is meaning. We just infuriate the use of opposites. For example, someone has failed an exam, someone is very sad after failing, and you go and tell that person, congratulations, you are very intelligent for failing the exam. When you mean the person is down, that is irony. For example, again, your child, maybe your daughter has broken your phone or has broken something very expensive in the home. And you come, you start clapping, bravo, congratulations for breaking my phone or breaking the television. When you mean, this is a very bad act you have done. After irony, the second literary device is paradox. Paradox is a figure of speech where the writer uses a contradictory statement, but which have a lot of truth in it, which is usually deep in meaning, a statement that contradicts itself. Here, the writer or the speaker just contradicted himself. For example, someone can say, the noise of silence. That is a contradictory statement. There cannot be noise and silence at the same time. Someone can say, up and down. You understand me, you and I, you understand, you cannot go up and down. Someone can say it was a sunny, dark day. A day cannot be sunny and dark at the same time. Someone can say, I was happy, happy, sad. You cannot be happy and sad at the same time. Someone can say, when I'm poor, I'm rich. You are poor, you are poor. When you are rich, you are rich. You cannot be poor and rich at the same time. So, those are contradictions. They contradict each other. The third one is called oxymoron. Oxymoron is a literary device where the writer uses contradiction side by side. An oxymoron is a paradox, but there is no difference. It's a paradox, but here specifically, the writer or the speaker use contradiction side by side. For example, up and down. Someone can say, I was going up and down. This person is using oxymoron. But this oxymoron, at the same time, is a paradox. Someone can say, daylight. Can you say, okay, sorry, not daylight, dark day. This is an oxymoron because the contradiction is side by side. So today's lesson, it was just about those three literary devices. The first one is irony, the second one paradox, and the third one is oxymoron. Thank you for following me and watching my videos. Continue watching my videos for the literary devices which are going to come. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube page. Until we meet again, goodbye.